guys, so today we're gonna do inspiration pick on Kayla here, and this is what she wants. So here we go. I'm going to kind of go with her natural parting right there. I'm going to do this in segments. Alright, so, her parting. It's pretty short already, so I'm just going to flip it out of my way. Same thing on the other side. In this back area and work my way up. Start in the nape area, and I'm just going to take this off just like her hairline, but I'm going to do it more rounded. So starting off, I might have to take this a little bit finer, so we're going to start off like our square. Since it's so short already, I just want to take that out of my way. Right. Make her look down, get your horizontal parting right there, and go with that hairline right in the middle. Remember, we are going to make this more rounded. So I just want to kind of go around the hairline on the edges. Sides. So pretty much whatever hangs over my guide, that's what I'm going to take off next. This more of a area that I can raise up. With my horizontal parting still. Whatever hangs over that hairline guide, that's what I'm taking off. as you'll notice, on this side, just rounding that little corner is not going to be enough. All this hair, just like her hairline, all the way up to the ear line, is going to be right at that hairline. So pulling that hair over past that hairline and making your guide go up around the ear. You don't want to take it too close to the hairline, but just pull that hair over because we're going to put layers in there. Same thing on this side. Just like right here, all that length I'm taking off because it's going to be right at our hairline. So I'm going to pull this hair past this hairline and then just connect it. To that bottom corner that I'd already rounded off. Moving up my section, I'm going to take a diagonal going with her hairline. Bringing that all over past the ear. Clip out. And I'm just going to follow my guide right up to that back of the ear. Pulling that hair with that comb. Just as long as you can see through that hair and that hairline, you're safe to pull it down. You're not going to cut that ear. You're good to cut. Maybe right at the top of the ear, you want to hold on to it and just work a little bit of a section. As close as you can hang on to that scalp, but I like to just pull it down with that comb and go right into my guide. Okay. Hold it down right past that hairline. Trim that real nice and neat. Okay. Don't worry about that section up there. We'll get to that. Now we're going to take the diagonal back section again. And just whatever hangs over that guide, I'm going to take off to that length. Right, we're in the area that it doesn't reach anymore because she already had layers, so we're good to move on. We're going to work on the other side, going up right behind the ear. This side, diagonal back section, right with her hairline. And like I said, as long as you can see through your section, you're good to go. If you can't, you're taking too big of a section, you need to take some of that out and save it for the next piece. So always follow your guide. Since I have a guide at the bottom, I'm going to follow that going up. kind of lean the head. See that rounded corner? Move on. Diagonal back. Pulling that hair over past your guide. Find your guide underneath. Pulling that hair. Holding it firmly in that fine tooth comb. This is where it naturally falls, so I'm not really pushing the hair anywhere past where it's gonna naturally go. Okay? And this, the next section won't reach, we're gonna move on. Okay, let's go with this side. So on this, I'm gonna take a horizontal but more of a diagonal forward. See that ear? Now here's our inspiration pick. This is what she wants. You see that point? And it's all the way off of her ear. That's what we're gonna do. Okay, so just following my guide from where I had back here on the top of the ear. Putting it down with that comb. And then slight angle with your comb to form that sideburn. Pointy as possible. Alright. If you want to do it freehand, then you can go back in with the comb. Just to get that point, dramatic. All right, and then the diagonal forward, just a slight bit. I mean, it's horizontal, but it's more of a diagonal forward because I was going with that sideburn. Just as long as we don't take any off of there, we're good. So as long as you can see your guide, hold that comb down. Follow the guide that you already put in there. Once you get to that point of the ear point again, you want to just do it freehand and clean it up in a minute. Okay. Just working my section up. Whatever falls over my guide, that's what I'm taking off. Again, hair back, freehand it. All this is going to be pretty much that one length, but we're going to do some face framing in that area. So now, anything that falls, it's not going to go past my guide, pretty much. Same thing on this side. My diagonal forward section. Okay. I'm just going to follow that guide right at the top of the ear, right there. And connect it to the front like we did the other side. So on this, I'm going to start where my guide is. So anything that hangs over that guide, on the top of that ear, just like I did the other side. And then once you get to here, like I said, you can always freehand it. It's going to be a little bit harder to freehand on this side, but take that thinner type of comb and just get that length off, pushing that back, and then work your way up to that guide. We can finish it up as we move on. Diagonal forward again, along with my guide. Whatever hangs over that guide, that's pretty much what I'm taking off. I'm going to start in the back, connect my guide to that. My guide underneath, like that, and then like I said, I'm just going I'm pretty much freehand that. Again, it's horizontal but more of a diagonal forward. And then just whatever hangs over that. So not very much. Just go in there from the very bottom. And just check, make sure nothing's hanging over. That comb right on the top of the ear. Area left and a little bit of face frame, and then just maybe touching up the back, but mainly she just wanted it cleaned up and looking nice. You can always take a little bit more off of this area whenever we're in the face frame so that she can pull it forward or she can go back. She likes it more of a swoopy bang. So we're going to start off on the thinner part. Put this out. So you see all this nice and layered already towards her face, but more of what she's wanting out of her eyes. So as I pull that forward, I mean, that's a lot of hair that we're looking at. So I'm going to take my vertical section, pulling that forward with my fingers and kind of texturize that a little bit and take some of that length off. So pull that forward, hold that out, and we can take off some of that length so we're not totally in our eyes. Recomb it. So now it's not going to hang totally in our eyes. Anything back here, you can pull it past. Take your next vertical section. Pull that hair forward. Anything that hangs over that guide, you can take off, but also you can go in and point cut. So it makes it more texturized look, but it's not going to hang in her eyes if she does pull it forward. So I'm just taking that comb, just a little bit on the ends. She already had it all layered. It was all like a 90 degree But she didn't very much like it. I mean, she's kind of heavy right through that area. But other than that, she's all pretty much that 3.5 inches all over. So she didn't have much of a bang in the beginning. But this is what you start off with whenever or after you've shaved your head. You'll grow into type of a 90 degree haircut. So what I'm doing is just pulling that bang area down since she doesn't want a bunch of length off, and going in there and point cutting those bangs. Just to make them texturized, just like I did on that side. I can pull it down with my comb, but I want to get underneath it, pull it forward. Just take off that blunt edge. Okay. As I'm working on this side, she wants it to be into that longer piece. So I'm going to over direct that forward, right like that, and put that point cutting in there. But I don't want to take off any length in this area because she's willing to grow this side out. Of her ears and everything. She is a little bit full right in that area. You see that point there? We could take off that to get that blunt area off of there. So now I'm going to do my horizontal or vertical sections, pulling that out, finding that point, and just taking that little point in there and blending it in. Remember, she's trying to grow out of hair, so this is just going to be just getting that weight off of there. She wanted to go off the ears and stuff like that because she just wants more length on top. But this cute little style, right? If you find that after you go back in and you're doing your vertical sections and you have some weight down there, go all the way down and just layer that out. Is holding it out, my vertical section, like a 90 degree, and taking off that bulk. There's just like a little point in there. Move it up my section. Point. Right there. Pulling it out. Taking off some of that bulk area. The part where she wants to grow out is going to be the top of her hair, so I'm just following that hairline just like I did back here. I'm using that as a guide to take that bulk area out. And I always have that guide. It's a traveling guide. I'm just using that guide to take that weight off the sides and the back up into my guide on the top that she wants to keep at 3.5 inches. But 3.5 inches isn't really going to work on the sides for it to be not bulky. So holding it out, I'm taking it at 2 inches. So she's got 2 inches back in the sides. 3.5 on top. So as I get to the top, right by that parietal ridge, I'm making it go into my guide. So I'm over directing that hair. Now here on the side, I have that face frame, that guide right there. Take some of that weight out. Problem is, she wants some to be long. So right up here, I'm going to pull that back and over direct that back, so I'm not taking all that length off of there either, but I'm taking that weight out of there so it blends. So even my front hairline, I will drag back onto where I started this, two previous sections, find by my guide, cut it with that guide. That way I'm not taking that length off and she can still have that side sweep bang that she's wanting to grow out to be. Alright. So there is your new trendy haircut. Well, what do you think? And I can still take some weight off of there. But she's wanting to build it up right through there. And I can go in here with texturizers and stuff like that, but that's a whole new video. Thanks for learning. Bye.